So you've got your alto sax and you are ready to put it together. So the first thing that you want to do is check your case for any labels or markings so that you know where the top is versus the bottom. And the reason why is because if you open it upside down, your instrument's going to come tumbling out and it can potentially damage some of the keys or the instrument. So this case does not have any markings. What you're looking for is like maybe a label of some kind for the brand of instrument that it is. If you're not sure, if your instrument doesn't have a label, take a look at the front where the latches are, okay? And you'll notice that the top is going to be a little bit smaller than the bottom, and that makes sense because the instrument is sitting down in the case, okay? And so if there's no label, you can put, you know, a piece of tape on the front or maybe just a sticker or something so that you know, okay, this is the top, this is how I open it every time. So when you undo the latches and you open up your instrument, there's the alto sax, okay? So once you've figured that out, what I would do is put it on a nice flat surface on the ground, on your desk. Not your bed, not a chair, right, where it could tip off. Nice flat surface. The alto sax has a couple important pieces, okay? You have the neck, the mouthpiece, the ligature, the body of the instrument, and last but not least, your neck strap. So the first thing that you want to do is put your neck strap on, okay, so it's ready to go. Take the neck and the body of the instrument, and really carefully you're going to put these two together. You'll notice that there's a pin that's coming up on one side of the neck of the instrument. So just mind this pin. And you'll notice also that there's a loop here on the side of the neck of the mouthpiece. Okay? So those two are going to join up. Okay? What you want to do is just wiggle a little bit back and forth. You don't want to smash it in. You don't want to force it at all. Just little wiggles back and forth. If it seems like it's kind of sticky, make sure that the screw is loose here, okay? And if it's still pretty sticky, all you need to do is just wipe off the neck of the instrument with a dry cloth and make sure there's not any extra residue or anything on there, okay? So then once those two are together, the instrument and the body of the instrument has a thumb rest here. It's this black circle on this instrument. Sometimes it can be silver, sometimes it can be gold, but it's almost always just a nice pad here. Okay, so the neck should be facing this pad. So I'm going to just adjust it so that those two are in line, and hopefully you can see that a little bit, that those are mostly in line. Okay, next you have your mouthpiece. Okay, now the mouthpiece has this solid side and then an opening. Okay, so the opening is going to go in that same direction towards the thumb rest there, right? So everything is sort of in line. And when you put it on the cork, same thing, just little wiggles, little wiggles. Then your last piece, the ligature, which just goes right on the top. And no matter what kind of ligature you have, if it's metal, if it's like this one over here that's leather, the screws or the knobs are always going to be on the right side, okay? So screws are on the right side. And then you'll be able to clip in on your instrument with your neck strap, okay? Watch the next video for how to put on your reed.